26th, of course, Memorial Day, and in just a few short weeks, it'll be Flag Day on June the 14th. There are 2 days created to focus on our military sacrifice and our country. What comes to mind when you think of these days? Are they merely a chance to enjoy a backyard barbecue? Well, in today's OIO in the community segment, retired First Sergeant Paul Joseph has some thoughts on how our generation can teach the other generations to respect these holidays, and also introduces us to a special military memorial housed right here in Allen County.
This monument that we're here today is at the Army Reserve Center located at the corner of Reed Road and Shawnee Roads here in Lima, Ohio. It was an Eagle Scout project incepted and designed back in 2006 by local Eagle Scout Kyle Beck. He has done so in honor of his brother, his older brother, Andy, who's also serving right now in Kuwait as we speak here today. He's on his third combat tour as well. The monument itself is a five-sided monument, and it is designed to honor the four deceased soldiers from the 93rd Engineer Battalion who were killed in 2005 while serving in Iraq. On the fifth side of this monument, as we go around as well, you will see that there is a picture of the entire battalion as it was assembled in FOB Spiker, which is north of Tikrit. As we take a look at each side of the monument here, we have Specialist Kendall Frederick. Specialist Frederick came from Chicago, Illinois, and served with us as a cross-leveled soldier. The next soldier you see here is Specialist Gary Andy Eckert. Sergeant Eckert, as he was later promoted posthumously, was served two combat tours as well. He was injured by an IED in 2003, came back again for his second tour in 2005, and unfortunately was killed during that time by an IED blast as well. The battalion consisted of 688 soldiers who were present. We had approximately 44 soldiers who were cross-leveled in and out due to rotations, injuries, or even the deaths that we did sustain. The engineer battalion came together. We deployed in December of 2004. We returned home late in December of 2005. We do rely on our military, of course, to help provide for our peace and in wartime as well. But the Memorial Day, which is originally Decoration Day, is more of a time to recognize and honor the dead who have served our country. And of course, on June 14th, which is Flag Day, the flag which all of our service members have served under at one time, we need to be able to honor our flag and know and respect it as well. And we need to pass on this information to the generations to come, both now and long after we're gone as well. The key on this here, of course, is knowledge and information. What we know to be true about how to honor our flag. We need to teach our younger generations today the importance of it and why we do that, why we do respect our flag at all times. As far as our military history and those which carry that, both as our older generations, which are now passing, take time to stop and listen and ask. And for our military members out there as well too, every single one of you has a story to tell. No matter what you did, what branch, what your job was, you need to share that experience and that in total, all that history onto generations as well, family and friends.